Good morning, guys. We are here at the Tim Hortons parking lot getting our supplies to head out to Marine Lake. Wayne's here as well. we're heading out to Marine Lake. Just gonna go enjoy the scenery, take some photos. Then we're gonna head into Banff for a little bit and wander around there. For anyone who doesn't know what Marine Lake is, it's a world famous lake in the mountains. It's constantly debated that photos posted online of it are photoshopped. We are gonna show you that it's not. It's actually that blue. It's that real. Crazy. Yeah, it's real. that's what our plan is for today. And let's go.
And what I'm gonna be doing today as well is I'm gonna be tracking macros because I'm getting all these questions about like diets and you know, how to get your macros into your daily foods. But I'm gonna be doing it in a way that it's like out and about. Like when you eat, I don't have any meal prep going on here. Basically, I've had my breakfast, but every other meal from here on out is gonna be fast food, I guess. So I'm gonna try and get my 240 grams of carbs, my 240 grams of protein, and my 50 grams of fat, all from fast food. And get as close to it as possible. 2400 calories I'm gonna be consuming. And yeah, let's see, put it to the test. We'll be using, of course, my Fitness Pal and give it a shot. Alrighty.
Do you know what you're gonna get?
Black coffee.
I'm gonna get tea.
I'm just too grounded, guys.
I so wish I wasn't doing this today. I'd eat lots of this.
They do look good.
Good, yeah.
It's so good. I love the tea.
I got me a cold brew.
She didn't know what I meant when I said cold brew.
No, only
I respected that.
Only the cool people at Starbucks don't understand that.
Yeah, I was like, yeah, you're right. I want an iced coffee.
Tasty, tasty though. So yeah, if anybody just want help, as I mentioned before, setting up their diet, setting up their macros, DM me on Instagram or leave a comment down below. And like the video, please.
Yeah.
Big thumbs up.
Big thumbs up. I'm excited.
Ahoy, hoy. So we just pulled into Canmore to stop for a whizzy wazoo and to get some food before we go to Moraine Lake. So, fun fact, Canmore is the second most expensive place to live in Canada. So worth it. It is amazing. Little mountain town. West Vancouver is number uno. Anyway, we're gonna go in here and see what we can get and fill these macros.
Yeah. Subway. I'm so excited. Just...
Oh yeah.
The smell of Subway.
Yeah. So, fail of the day so far. We don't have the nutrition information, but luckily my Fitness Pal has it all in there already. And I think I'm gonna get the oven roasted chicken sub.
Yeah.
Maybe with extra chicken.
What was it called?
Maps Basketball.
Maps?
Yeah. Oh yeah?
Yeah.
Alrighty, so oven roasted chicken with extra chicken for the protons. So we're gonna check out in my Fitness Pal what we got. So my Fitness Pal has been a bit of a pain to focus on what we're trying show you here. So I'm going to post them a screenshot of all these meals, I guess. So as I said, oven roasted chicken sub, 320 calories, 47 carb, 5 fat, 23 protein. We added in another chicken breast for the extra protons, which came in at 80 calories, 4 carb, 2 fat, 2.5 fat, and 14 grams of protein. So yeah, super macro friendly option, that's for sure. But yeah, before going into any of these fast food joints, take out your MyFitnessPal and, you know, make an educated decision on what you're going to be buying or purchasing or eating, should I say. The thing I find the hardest when eating out and about is getting enough protein in a meal. So if you have to add in an extra chicken breast or serving of whatever it might be to get the protein up, do so, and off you go. What did you get?
I got
Pure Leaf
lemon iced tea.
Lemon iced tea with
my favorite.
A million
160 calories.
160 calories, 41 grams of sugar, 41 grams of carbs.
For all your sugar needs.
For all your insulin spikes.
It's so good though.
What did you get for sandwich?
I got a 6-inch Italian BMT.
Oh yeah.
On Italian herb and cheese bread.
Oh yeah.
With lettuce, spinach, onions, and cucumbers,
mm-hmm.
white cheese, and honey mustard and salt and pepper. Do you want me to tell you what mine comes in at? Okay, it's the Italian BMT butt. Auto-corrected. All right, so we got 45% carbs.
45 grams? Oh, 40, what, show me. 45, okay, 46 grams of carbs.
16 grams of fat and 20 grams of protein.
Not bad.
Not bad, 410 calories.
What is this again?
Carrot
cake muffin. I will pass it the awesomeness along. They're actually quite tasty. Calorie content, 500,069 calories.
Legitimately, I think there's like 410 calories just in this.
Muffin gains.
Muffin gains, yep.
Oh. Hello, Banff.
Okay.
Not kill us.
Not kill us, yeah.
Free entry into the park because, what, Canada's 150 years old this year.
Yeah.
Which I don't understand, but.
Why don't you understand that? That's awesome.
Because, look, we're celebrating 150 years.
It's a milestone.
Yeah, I know, but Ireland is like, you know, thousands, well, Europe in general, I guess, and Canada's like, oh yeah, yeah, we just like gave birth to ourselves 150 years ago. No, you were always here.
We became a country. Signed the papers.
As in, the white man says you're a country.
Yeah, don't talk to the Indians or natives or whatever they want to be called. Sounds so horrible, but like.
Talk to the chief.
They're not very happy about the whole celebrating 150.
No, it's ridiculous.
But they weren't the country of Canada before we came here.
They were
whatever they wanted to call the country. Which is fine, but...
The country of the big, massive sky. Oh, that's racist. Mm-hmm. It looks pretty decent. Two patties. Mustard, pickles.
You just call them patties.
Well, that's what they call it there.
Really?
Yeah.
That's funny.
Mmm. More eating, less vlogging. So you're looking at Castle Mountain out there. Castle Grayskull from He-Man. It's a beast of a mountain. It's very, very impressive. You know, you can't quite see it. But yeah. Like if you want a remake of the He-Man movie. So check out these overpasses. They're like specifically built so all the wildlife can actually pass over the highway.
all the bears, the mooses, and the foxes, and the wolves, and the deer, and all that good stuff.
So we're, what was the last 14K up this windy road?
Yeah.
To Moraine Lake. And Moraine Lake is quintessential Canada mm-hmm. on a postcard.
Sweet. Catch your snack-a-latch.
Out of the car.
Yeah, I need to pee too, yeah.
Chili.
It's fresh, beautiful.
What is with this person? One of these things is not like the other.
What the heck?
Yeah, we're heading up the rock pile.
The rock pile.
There's always cute little chipmunks. Squirrels.
We brought Bronson here and he's a puppy. And we had to carry him up the steps. He wasn't having none of us. They weren't so bad.
He got to like here, and yeah. Then he was like, I'm done, I'm tired. Like,
I feel like they've done some work on these steps. People everywhere.
Pro tip, get here early.
Yeah, we're doing as much later people we normally see.
Yeah.
But it really wasn't that bad. Like parking and everything.
No.
The water is really high.
It is really high, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
For
like yeah. Normally we're like over there where those trees are.
Yeah.
Like there's like normally more like wood in the water that you can see.
Yeah. We'll go to a high point now in a minute too.
Yeah, it's like one of the most humbling places, I think. It's a place that like totally brings you down to earth and slaps all the bullshit out of your head, really. It's like,
it's very peaceful.
Incredibly.
So all along here is a trail that brings you down to a water kind of fall right down the back end also. And there is a weather station on the top of one of these peaks, and I just don't know which one it is. And yeah, see this one right here? This is the one that we're saying that, it's probably not, but it looks like there's like snowboard or skiing tracks from the top right down that little run there. I'm not too sure if it is, but this guy is pretty sociable. Hey, bud. What's happening? He's like, subway for me. You crazy old rodent, look at him.
Oh my goodness, I hope he doesn't come on me. That would actually kind of freak me out.
Hey buddy, he's like, hi. Look.
Where is he?
Right there, he's looking at you.
I'm kind of like intimidated by them, because they're so cute, but I feel like they'd be just be like, rah.
Parkour.
He's as hard as a fortress.
Wayne spotted a fruit bowl. I went for the sugar cookie.
Sugar cookie and tea.
Sugar cookie and tea. Give me some fuel for the fire.
Yeah. My phone is dying, so I decided to pop in all my macros and what I'm going to eat for the day into my phone now. So I logged my yogurt parfait. I'm going to get a booster juice with added protein in there. And then on the way home, we're going to go to this Greek place called Opa. It's a big chain of Greek food, does some good stuff. And I'm going to get a pita wrap with chicken skewers, and yeah, that'll be my challenge complete for the day. It's looking pretty good for macros and calories, so yeah, you'll be surprised that if you do that on a daily basis, it can be done, but why do it when you can meal prep, right? But yeah, I'll post that up at the end of the video. You can see how we did. Did we ever eat at did we go up there?
No, that was your other girlfriend.
Oh yeah.
No, we didn't.
Rustic style.
Yeah. That's a copper cool roof. Only in Canada is a nightclub called the Dancing Sasquatch.
Nice. Yes. So that's a thing that people don't really know about is beaver tails.
Oh yeah.
What it is, it's actually a pastry, like, isn't it?
Yes. Do you care to explain what it is?
No idea. I just seen on the TV the other day. People were asking the Canadians what the hell's beaver tail.
For all of you who don't know what a beaver tail is, like all these people who are about to find out.
You actually see them in
there. Yeah, kind of. A beaver tail is basically like, yeah, it's a pastry, like a flat, like rolled out pastry, and then they put like cinnamon sugar and icing, or you can get like basically anything put on it, but it's very Canadian, and we like our fatty deep fried foods, what can we say?
Girl turns to the other girl back there and says, quick shot in the elk. It's like, let's go for it.
Nice. Oh.
Pretty tasty. Alrighty, so we had some technical difficulties, as in both camera batteries crapped out, so we couldn't film our meal in Opa, the Greek place, but I had a chicken pita wrap and 4 chicken skewers, super tasty and super big. Their macros are on the screen right now. So let's sit back and relax, watch the water, and I'll take you through my full day of convenience, on the fly, whatever you want to call it, kind of eating, and where it landed me for my macros and calories for the day. I had 3 goals. Number 1 was to get my protein over 180 grams, or as close to 240 as possible. Number 2 was to keep my fat under 50 grams for the day. And number 3 was not to go over 2,400 calories for the day. Now, I am still in a deficit in terms of diet, but I will be bumping that up very soon. Looking at numbers, we did manage to achieve all goals. Happy days. Calories came in slightly low, but that last meal was pretty big. I just didn't feel like having any more food afterwards, so I was pretty much fit for bed. Fat was well below 50 grams, so that's a big win too. And protein was actually in the mid-range. It was about 210, I think, for where I wanted it to be. So that's, again, a win. So to sum up, you can eat out on the fly, still make great choices, and that will fill your dietary and fitness needs. It's kind of simple, really, as long as you track your meals with my fitness pal. I can't stress it enough. If you track it, you'll have no worries whatsoever. And practice makes perfect when it comes to it. You know, the more you use it, the easier it gets, and the more you kind of start to understand food and where you need to get your protein, your fats, and your carbs from, and how to get them from whatever product it might be or a choice it might be. And anyone who wants help constructing a meal plan, a diet, whatever it might be, drop me a DM on Instagram or leave a comment below.
What side do you want to be on?
Hey guys, so it is Sunday morning and we forgot to end the vlog last night. Yeah, so we're just here at the dog park this morning. We thought we would sign off here and kind of catch you, wrap everything up, and yeah.
Check you later. until next week when we actually go to...
I don't know what we're doing next week.
Johnston Canyon.
Oh yeah, we're going to Johnston's Canyon next week. So that'll be good. And it'll be...
And potentially gondola.
We're doing gondola?
Yes. Silver Mountain.
Okay. Very nice.
Yeah.
All right, so yeah, we're just gonna wrap things up here. So thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget
to like, subscribe, and share.
Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. It means so much to us. And we'll see you guys next time. Bye.
Bye.